Aan die je hebt. Maar wat je dan als kind, tenminste dat kan ik me herinneren, wat ik als kind in de impressionistische boeken zag, dat zijn natuurlijk resultaten. Dat zijn gewoon plaatjes van die Franse en ik keek ook naar de Russische impressionisten. Thank you. Thank you.
So maybe you know that situation when you were working on several paintings. There is always a painting waiting to be finished. You put it somewhere in a corner in your studio. And it just waits there till you finish it. And after several days or weeks, you notice that you feel some kind of fear to finish it because you have to touch it. When it's becoming a good painting, the fear is stronger than when it's a bad painting. So you have patience and you let it wait and wait. And then the next situation is that you feel you aren't able to finish it. The thing that's going wrong is that you are only thinking about finishing that painting. When you started that painting, you were not thinking about completing or finishing the painting, you were just painting. But still there is a fear. So I have this larger marching band watercolor painting, and it was there on the corner while I was working on these commissioned house portraits, and I was really looking forward to finish it. And then I take it and I actually don't know how to finish it. I only know that I have to awake the painting. The only thing you have to do when you awake a painting is just take the next step. It's not that step that will finish the painting, it's just the next step. And I don't want to care about if this step is a good step or a wrong step. It's just a step. Actually, it's the next question. So I just put paint on the paper to see what happens. It's a question. And then there comes an answer. And then the next step is another question. So it's again a conversation between you and the paper, between you and the painting. And now it's not sleeping anymore. So it's getting dark, I have to go home. And I think I know what I can do tomorrow to maybe finish it. I'm curious if it's possible to frame these marching bands paintings without glass. They are becoming larger and larger, and then it will become more difficult to frame these with glass, and if it's still possible, it will be more expensive as well. Larger sizes glass, and sometimes I use this non-reflective glass with a UV protector in it, and this is really more expensive, and certainly in these sizes it will become very expensive and heavy too. So I've been looking for something that I can use instead of glass, and then I found this here in the shop in the street. It's not a varnish, but it's a protector, a UV protector, and you can use it on photographs, oil, acrylics, gouache, pastel and watercolor as well. What I want to do now is use these papers that they offered me last week, these trials. I will put some watercolor, pastel and gouache on it, so that these are the techniques I'm using in my marching band series. And then I put on one part, I put a layer of this over it, and then the other part will be covered. And I will lay this down somewhere under a window, and after several weeks I want to compare those two parts, the covered part and the uncovered part protected by this liquid. When it looks the same, I can trust this one. But first I have to see how it looks like when I cover pastel and watercolor paint with this. Fortunately, I did this outside. It's the smell is very, very strong and horrible, poison. So it has been drying several minutes outside in the garden. This is the varnished part. This is the unvarnished part. And to me, they look the same, so that's good. I think I will stick this to the window. This window is at the south part of the house, so it will catch some sun, if there will be sun. But it will stay there for a few weeks. And I'm really curious how it looks like, how it will look like after several weeks. I will let you know. Thank you. It's getting dark and I totally forgot time. I'm so focused on this series. Now I know how I want to build up these paintings with several deep, deep colored layers, warm and cold. And it's so great to let the watercolor paint dry and just touch it a little, add a few colors sometimes, a few effects, and then just sitting and waiting to see what happens. I can't wait to get on with this. And I already bought a few papers 2 times bigger than this one. So then we have a size, well, like this table, a bit bigger. I don't know how to get them outside because I have to carry them downstairs when they're framed, you know. But that's another question. First, I want to make larger watercolor paintings with this subject. Normally I'm fascinated by light and by movement, and now there became sound in the painting as well. And making music together outside, walking musicians. I only took 2 good pictures of this subject last year. I saw them again this month when Saint Nicholas arrived, but the weather was very bad. It was raining and it was dark, but last year it was so clear, crispy, warm winter light. So I only can use these 2 bad pictures, and I don't mind. Everything is in it, and the colors and the effects. They just appear on the paper. They are not that strong on the pictures, but it just yeah, it's really cool. Thank you for watching this adventure. I will finish this maybe next week. I don't know. I have to start a large oil painting, commissioned oil painting, a really nice house portrait as well, and do some sketches. So maybe it has to wait, we will see. But thank you for joining me in the process and the thoughts, and for writing those interesting comments. Enjoy your weekend. I see you next week. Thank you.